After finding the clusters in our dataset, the next task is to figure out what kind of cells these clusters are made of. One option is to look at the differentially expressed genes between the clusters, and based on those, and combined with one's own knowledge and lists of known biomarkers, to identify the cell types present in each cluster. Another, more automatic and independent method is to annotate the cells or clusters by comparing them to readily labeled reference datasets. In Chipster, we have wrapped the single R tool and the CellDex package. As an input for this tool, you give the Seurat object after clustering step. So this Seurat object contains the clustering information. In the parameters of the single R tool, you select the CellDex reference data you wish to compare the data with. This tool will then compare both the individual cells as well as the clusters in your Seurat object to the labeled reference data. Scores are given to each label based on similarity, and the highest scoring label is then selected. As an output, Chipster gives a Seurat object containing the annotations as well as two tables with the number of cells matching each label and a PDF with several plots. In the PDF file, the first plot shows the clusters in a UMAP plot. This is just a reminder and to ease the comparison to the next plots. So this is something you have already seen in the clustering step. Next plot shows the same UMAP plot, but now the clusters are colored according to their main annotations. So this first comparison is done cluster-wise. The third and the fourth plot show the annotation for each individual cell, both in main level and on finer level. After these two plots, we see the confidence or quality plots, both for main level and fine level annotations, in the case of cell-wise predictions. The heat map shows each cell as a column and the cell type from the annotation data as a row. Color of the cell indicates the level of the score. Yellow means high score and blue lower score. Ideally, each cell should have one score that is obviously higher than the rest, indicating that it is unambiguously assigned to a single label. The violin plots of delta scores tell a similar story in a little bit different way. Delta score here means the difference between the score for the assigned label and the median across all labels for each cell. Lower delta means more uncertainty, or in other words, poor or unambiguous prediction. Very poor quality deltas are pruned or removed from the data, and these cells are shown in yellow in the violin plot. Uncertainty in the data can mean that the actual cell type's label is not present in the reference data set.